I'm really happy to introduce today's resource person, Dr. Ajit Kumar. Ajit Kumar, an expert in the field of education technology, is serving as an assistant professor in the School of Education, IGNU, New Delhi. IGNU Indira Gandhi Open University, one of the leading open university in Commonwealth Asia, I can say. He has completed his master's in science education and master's in physics and MPhil from Calicut University, Kerala. And he has completed one of the reputed course, that is PGDDE, Postgraduate Diploma in Distance Education. And he started his career as a higher education, high secondary teacher, and has 15 years of experience in teaching in higher education and secondary education. He has published various edited books, research papers, articles at national and international level as a report. And his area of interest are education technology and statistics in educational researches and social science researches, and as well as in the field of open and distance learning. He is continuously engaged in delivering expert talks in seminars, workshops, and developing various contents for MOOC delivery, as well as e-contents for various purposes in open and distance learning. Thank you very much. It's a very good privilege for us having you with us, Dr. Ajit. And now I would like to request Dr. Ajit, please start your proceedings and hands-on activities in this training program. Thank you very much, Dr. Ajit.
Thank you, Dr. Manas ji. Respected my senior colleague, Madam Professor Madhu Prahar, Nisha ji, Dr. Jitendra, Dr. Ashish, Dr. Gopal ji, and all the participants who are joining from various parts of the blog. It's my privilege. I welcome all the participants to this second day. Also, I will take this opportunity to thank Simca and Open University of Uttarakhand for giving such an opportunity. Today, my presentation would be, I'll give how I'm going to move about in today's session. The first few minutes will be a introductory kind of thing, where I'll be giving few theoretical aspects. It won't be taking more than 5 minutes. Then I will be directly moving on to my workshop mode of lecturing, where, as Dr. Ashish did yesterday, I'll be demonstrating some of the things. Then some of the things I will demonstrate and will give you some time for practicing at your end. When you're practicing, let me tell you, you can minimize your Zoom window, then you can practice in your laptop itself. So I would request all the participants to join the Zoom meeting in their laptop. Why? Because in mobile, doing practical workshop online will be a little difficult. So this is one thing. The second thing is, it's little difficult that way to cover within 1.5 hours the whole Google Classroom. So I would try to prove justice to myself by giving some of the important concepts, some of the important aspects which are there in Google Classroom and which you will get as the theoretical lecture, as well as you can practice at your end. So I would try my level best to confine to this time frame and will cover as much as possible. Thank you once again, Samka, Madhu Madam, Manasi, and Uttarakhand Open University team for providing this wonderful opportunity. So with this introductory remark, I would like to share my screen. Dr. Banasi, I think my screen is visible now.
Yeah, your screen is visible.
Thank you. So friends, as this schedule was circulated, this is our second day, and today we are going to learn and practice something about Google Classroom. So as I said in the beginning, I'm going to make you glance through some of the theoretical aspects which are there in, which are associated with Google Classroom that way. The first thing is this slide. I mean, like, this is prepared because I had already given you some pre-workshop activity, and I hope you are ready with this menu. You should have course details. It's better if you have a small video, which of course, how you will prepare video, audio, everything will be, you know, discussed in tomorrow's session. Then it's better to have some OER components, OER elements, OER material, which you will going to, you know, which you are going to study in the fourth day. Apart from that, some of the, you know, menu you should have with you is something like, you should have your assignment questions, discussion forum, then some assessment questions, images, web links, students' email IDs. At least if you have 5 students' email IDs, it's good. So I hope all my participants are ready with this menu so that when we are practicing our real Google Classroom creation, you can easily pick out these elements and upload in your Google Classroom. So I hope you all are ready with these materials. Little bit about virtual classroom. I won't be taking much time. Virtual classroom, when you are searching the literature, what I found, a simple definition is like, it's a simply a digital version of a conventional face-to-face traditional classroom. As you see in the slide, and as Dr. Ashish discussed yesterday, traditional classrooms are where the real teaching, learning, physical presence of both the teacher and student are present. While in a virtual classroom, the whole process which is happening in a real classroom, face room classroom, is replicated in a digital world, in a cyber space. So when a conventional classroom, digital classroom is replicated in a digital space, virtual world, such a classroom is virtual classroom. And as Ashish said yesterday, in traditional classroom, what all things you will find? You will find the teaching, you will find students discussing, teachers assessing students' performance. Then there can have some kind of a blackboard in real classroom teaching situation. So all those facilities will be available in virtual classroom as well. So whatever things, it's not completely available, but a major percentage of processes which we are seeing in a traditional classroom will be available in the virtual classroom. So in a virtual classroom, similar to the traditional classroom, you will find tools like messaging tools, video classes. Then there is an option for sharing your learning materials, textbook, PDF and all. Then you can have the real-time chat. There will be facilities for what we call the library. Then the whole process will be administered and managed in a virtual space. And similar to Blackboard, we will have a virtual board in virtual classroom. So these are just to give an idea, understanding about what all materials, what all tools are available in a virtual classroom. Now being, I hope most of our participants are from Open University. So as a faculty from Open University or traditional university, you should think of what are your requirements when you are going for creating a virtual classroom. So basically, in a traditional classroom, what all things we are doing, that has to be replicated in a virtual classroom also. So mostly, your requirements fall under this broad framework where you will share materials, you will teach, you will assess students, will give grades, then discussion will happen, collaborative learning experiences will be there through discussion board, then there will have asynchronous and synchronous communication. So as a open distance education faculty or a conventional educational institution faculty, most of your requirements fall under this broad framework where you need to have all these materials in your virtual class. So then in such a case, how do we set up a virtual class? One of the easiest and simplest method would be, or tool would be, a solution would be the learning management systems. And the definition says it's very simple. Learning management is nothing but it's a system where you can manage the whole teaching learning process. So whatever is there associated with a classroom, traditional classroom or virtual classroom, the whole process, if we can manage in a virtual space, such a software application, such an app, such a computer program, we call as LMS software. So in a traditional classroom, we see many activities. The same is replicated in a virtual classroom. And to manage the activities in a virtual classroom, we make use of the LMS softwares. See, there is a website which is called the Center for Learning and Performance Technologies. You can see the source at the lower side of my presentation. This website, they categorize, they rank all the technologies which are available for teaching learning purposes. And the ranking usually is done for the first 200 tools. So in the screen, you can see I have taken the popular LMSs which are coming under that 200 ranking, of which Moodle stands at the 50th place, Canvas, Totara Learn, Axonify, Blackboard, and the sixth you can see the Google Classroom. So friends, when we are talking about the LMS, the best option I would suggest, I hope many of my colleagues also would agree to that, they will suggest Moodle. Why? Because in Moodle, you have plenty of options. I repeat, in Moodle, Moodle is one of the best available platforms, which is also free for as an LMS platform. But those who are not that much tech savvy, those who prefer some kind of a user-friendly LMS package, then of course they can go for the Google Classroom, which is also a good platform where you have plenty of options, but it's not that much compared to the Moodle. So that way, my introduction is over. We were talking about the traditional and virtual classroom. Virtual classroom is possible through LMS packages. And one of the popular LMS packages is the Google Classroom. So now I am done away with my 1 minute. I have done my introductory section. Now we are going to, our real, what we call the real workshop mode. So friends, as I said, Google Classroom is a LMS platform. When we are talking about Google Classroom, you should have a little bit idea about the type of Google accounts. Actually, Google is a big branded company, which is having number of, but they have a considerable number of account creation options. The two popular options, as you see in the slide, could be, 1 minute, let me reduce my. Is the Google account, which is personal, then the other is the G Suite account. There are two, these are the two popular accounts. One is the Google account, which is, is created for our personal purposes. And I hope many of you may be having this kind of accounts. My personal Gmail account is this ajitchalil at the rate gmail.com, where my organization, they have a collaboration. They have, collaboration with the Google company, and they have the G Suite account also. So usually the G Suite account is taken by the educational organization. So then in that case, your Gmail account will stand like this. Will have a domain of your institution, ajitchalil@ignor.ac.in. So friends, why I am saying this? Because you can have Google Classroom, you can create Google Classroom both in your personal account and your G Suite account. I don't know how many of you are having the G Suite account and how many of you are having the, I mean, like most of the people, of course, they will have the personal Gmail account. So when you go to your personal Gmail account, you can see something like this. I have taken the top extreme portion of my Gmail account where you can see these dots. In G Suite, it will be, you know, shown as G Suite account, G Suite. So this is my G Suite account interface. This is my personal Gmail ID interface. As I said, Google is a big company which is having number of tools. They are, you know, developing, they have developed number of tools. And all those tools you can access through your Gmail account or through the specific account. So if you want to access the Google tools through your Gmail account, you have to click on these dots, which is in square shape. Dr. Ashish was also explaining this yesterday. Similarly, in G Suite also, you can find the place, these dots, which you have to click to find the Google applications and Google tools. So this is one thing you should have idea about the Google account, personal and G Suite account. And in both the accounts, you can, you know, take the Google tools. Now coming to the one minute, I can't move forward. Yeah, so these are the Google applications. Very pretty simple. Many, many applications are there. Many, Dr. Ashish was discussing yesterday. He had already discussed it yesterday. Now see, there is something called G Suite for Education. This Google Classroom was part of the G Suite for Education, which was of course given to the G Suite account holders. So there is something called G Suite for Education, and Google Classroom was a part of this G Suite for Education. But after some time, Google made it free for all the account holders who are having a Gmail account or Google account. So I'm quickly making you to run through this. These are some of the features of Google Classroom, where you can upload learning documents, assignments, you can create queues. Stream is there for assignments. We'll come to that. Then you can have Classwork and Virtual Meet. So whatever, you know, things are happening in a traditional classroom is equally possible through the Google Classroom also. So friends, now let us move on to the real, what we call the hands-on sessions. Now, how would you access the Google Classroom? The first thing is that you have to have, you know, an account, or you have to, you know, sign in to the Google Classroom. How would you sign in for or into your Google Classroom? You can have two ways. One thing is either you can Google classroom.google.com. Let me repeat. There are two ways. Either you can click on this website, which is classroom.google.com, or you can go to your Gmail, you sign in your Gmail, then click on these dots, then you can see all the Google applications. So here you can see your Google Classroom also. So now we are accessing, you have access to your Google Classroom. When after accessing your classroom or after signing in your Google Classroom, this is how it will look like. Okay, since I have 2-3 classes in my Gmail account, you can see something like training. This is one of my classes. Then SLM EM is another class. So I have already two classes in my Google Classroom. If you want to see the classes, what out, either it will look like this. When you sign in through your Gmail, this interface, this window will come. And when you click on this parallel lines, there are three parallel lines you can see. When you click on this, as you see in this slide, when you click on this, you can see the classes, many things will come out. When you click on this parallel lines, friends, let me repeat, when you click on this three parallel lines, classes, calendar to do, all those will come out again. Okay. So these are my classes, training and SLEM. So this is how it will look like when you engage, when you sign in your Google account. See, when you sign in your Google account, the first thing that you will do is you will manage your profile, the first thing. So I'm not going to, you know, have a practice on this, how you can manage your profiles. To manage your profile, you have to simply go to your classroom. As I said, you have to click on these three parallel lines, which are on the left extreme side of your Google Classroom. Then at the end, at the top left side, bottom side, on the left side, you can see settings. You have to click on these settings. After you click on your settings, 1 minute, you can see all this. If you want to change your profile picture, you can change from here. Then there are plenty of options which are listed to the downside. If you want to switch on that, you can switch on, or if you want to keep it muted, you have to mute that. So this is how you have to manage your profile settings. We are not going to experiment that or practice that today. You can practice that at your end. So this is how it will look like. Now, friends, we are really practicing, going to practice. Okay. So I hope till now the things are clear. We will first sign in our Google Classroom, either through that website account or through your Gmail. So when you sign in your Gmail, this kind of a interface, this kind of a window will appear, where you can see on the right extreme top, there is a plus sign. There is an addition sign, plus. When you click on this plus sign, you will get two options. One is join class or create class. There are two options. You first sign in your Google Classroom, then you will find a window like this. Then on the extreme top side, you will find a plus sign, addition sign. You click on that, then you will get two options, one for joining a class, another for creating a class. See what happens when we click on creating class. As I said, there are two options, one for joining the class, other for creating the class. Joining class is for your students. If your students want to join in your class, they have to click on join class. If you want to create a classroom for your program, for your students, for the courses that you are running, you have to click on create class. Friends, this is why I was, you know, discussing about the types of Google accounts. This is how the window appears when you know, click on create class from your personal Gmail account. The right, you know, photograph image shows, this is how it will appear when you click on create class from your G Suite account. There are two things, personal Gmail ID, G Suite Gmail ID. If you click on hello, can you mute that? Some voice is coming. Okay. Thank you. So when you are signing in, when you are creating a Google Classroom from your personal Gmail ID, window, you will see this, you have to simply continue. Click on this, you can tick mark this. And if you are signing in or creating class from your G Suite account, this window appears. So this is why I was saying you have to be ready with your menu. You have to enter your course name here, section here, maybe you can give it like, there are many sections like postgraduate diploma programs are there, bachelor degree programs are there, postgraduate research degree programs. So you, for the time being, you give something like bachelor degree or postgraduate degree. Then if you are creating a room for, suppose your classroom is having 500 students. In a single classroom, you can accommodate only 250 students. Okay. In a single classroom, you can accommodate only 250 students. So if you want to have the same classroom for your rest of the 250 students, you have to have a separate room for your second batch of students. So room is for that. So friends, now I'll be giving you, I mean, like 5 minutes time. You go to your Gmail account, then you know, click on the you know, right extreme top. You will find that dots. Click on that. From that, pick out Google Classroom. Then new window will come. There you create your Google Classroom. Let me also demonstrate through my what we call Gmail ID. Manasi, is the screen is visible now? Can you see my Gmail?
No. Your slides slides are visible right now. You need to stop sharing.
Yes,
then you can share again. Yeah, it is coming. Yeah, it has come.
So friends, this is how. See, this is my G Suite account. You can see on the right extreme top G Suite account. Let me also take my Gmail, personal Gmail ID. Net is little bit slow here. So this is my personal G Suite account. I'll click on participants. Please listen. I'll click on this double. I think many of you may be having already the Google Classroom, but let us see. You have to click on this dots right extreme top. Then all the Google apps will come. I'll drag down. This is the Google Classroom. I have to click on Google Classroom. See, now the Google Classroom is loading. So this is my Google Classroom. I have three classes. This is one class, this is another class, this is the third class. So if I want to create a new class, I'll click on this plus sign. Friends, I'll click on to create a new class, I'll click on this plus sign. Then I will click on create class. So this window will come. So here you have to, you know, give all the details like your class, Semka. You. Okay, everything you can fill. For the time being, I am leaving it blank, creating. It's creating, you can see here, creating. This is my personal Gmail ID where you can't see the G Suite. Here also you have to click on these dots. Then you can see Google Classroom. Similarly, you do the same, you know, process which we have done for a G Suite account. It's very slow today. So this is my, you know, Google Classroom in my personal Gmail ID. This is my Google Classroom in my personal Gmail ID. This is my Google Classroom in my G Suite account. So friends, I would request you to take, you know, 2-3 minutes and, you know, quickly you can create a Google Classroom. Then we will see rest of the processes. So I'm, you know, stopping for 2-3 minutes, maybe 5 minutes maximum. You can minimize your Zoom window. You go to your Google Gmail. then click on this dot and create a Google Classroom. Is that okay, Manasji? Hello.
It's okay.
Okay.
If in between one question also raised,
sir.
You can respond to that. Roshni is asking. This happened with me. Okay. She has some problem, but it is now working.
Okay.
If in between, if anyone wants to ask a question also, you can just raise your hand in the Zoom that I can allow you. You can ask. Okay, Balamji and few people, they are raising their hand. I'm just allowing them. You please unmute your mic and ask question.
One more thing. I mean, like, as Hello. I said, there is.
Hello.
Anji, sir.
Hello. When I'm trying to open this, where there is a plus sign, there is only coming join class. There is no option to create class.
You are using from your personal Gmail ID.
Institutional Gmail ID is there, but then even personal also. The plus sign is there, but then there come only one option, join class, not the create class.
I mean, like, when you are clicking on plus sign, it should come. These two options should come. One thing you can do is what I guess is you should update, I think, your Windows system. Maybe then it will come. Okay, this is one option. Second, you can, if you are trying from one of your personal ID, you try in your second ID, second Gmail ID. You were saying you have two.
When I tried on the second Gmail ID, there also the same thing is coming. No.
Okay.
Yes, now I've got in the personal Gmail ID, it's now working. Thank you.
Yes. Okay. Friends, thank one you. More thing. I think you are practicing at your end. Let me also, give you some kind of input. There are, as I said, there is personal and G Suite account. This G Suite account, your organization has to take. Suppose you are working in some colleges or some universities, your university has to have a collaboration with the Google company. And then Google company will give you the G Suite account. Then in that G Suite account will be managed by your organization, and they will give you the G Suite kind of email ID where the organization name will be there along with your Gmail. This is one thing, and
Balam,
this is free.
Balam wants to ask a question probably. Balam wants to ask question. Can we take that question?
Yes.
Please, Balam.
We have two minutes more. We will quickly take that.
Balam, please ask your question. Or Roshini?
Yes, Dr. Ajit, this is Roshini. I have two accounts. I hope you can hear me. I have two accounts. My personal account works very well. I can create a classroom, and I've already created a classroom as well. But when Fine. I use my G Suite, the organization Gmail ID, it is asking me to choose a role. It says pick your role, and then there's I'm a student and I'm a teacher. When I teach, when I click on I'm a teacher, it says there was an error and please try again.
If some error message, you have to communicate this with your organization. There will be some kind of, error will be there. Okay.
Okay.
Thanks for that. To get all the features, your organization has to have a communication with the Google company. Then they will make all facilities available in your Google Classroom. Okay. What I am saying in Google Classroom, personal Gmail ID and G Suite, in personal Gmail ID, if you are accessing Google Classroom through personal Gmail ID, there are limited facilities. But if you are accessing Google Classroom through G Suite account, you will get plenty of options. This is one thing. Even if you are accessing through G Suite, there are limitations. Then in G Suite, there are various kinds of accounts. So if you want to access all the facilities, again, your organization has to pay for Google to access all the facilities. But with the basic account in G Suite, you can almost, you know, access all the facilities. This is one thing. So friends, let me move on to my presentation again. I hope you have created your slide. Coming to my presentation again, this is visible, I think. So this is how, when, yes, sir, thank you, sir. So this is how it will look like when you create a classroom. Okay, you will get something of this kind when you create a new classroom. So in this case, my classroom is training to this, the section is higher education. There is some mistake, but the class name is training to and the section is higher education. Okay, so this kind of a interface or window comes when you create a new classroom. Now let us see how you can, one more thing, when you are creating a new classroom, at the same time, it will create a Google Drive, sorry, a folder in your Google Drive also. This is the beauty part of your Google Classroom. See, I have created a, you can see in the slide, I have created a classroom here. When I am creating this classroom in the main page dashboard of your Google Classroom, you can see a small box here. There is something like an arrow also. When you click on this box, it will take you to your Google Drive. See, you are accessing through Gmail, then you are going to your Google Classroom, and from your Google Classroom, if you are clicking on this small box, it will take you to your Google Drive. So in your Google Drive, you can see, I'm placing my pointer here. This is the folder which I have created for this Google Classroom. So you don't have to create very, this is the beauty. You don't have to create a separate folder in your Google, what we call the Google Drive. When you create a Google Classroom, at the same time, it automatically creates a Google Drive folder in your Google Drive. So whatever materials you are creating, let me repeat, whatever materials you are creating in your Google Classroom, all those materials get stored in your this Google Drive folder. If you are creating something in Word file, that of course you have to upload it to your this folder. Otherwise, if you are creating something with your Google tools, all those, you know, materials will be stored in this Google, sorry, class folder. This is one thing. Now, friends, we are not going to practice this. How you will change the class settings? In your Google Classroom, on the right top, you can see a gear. Okay, a wheel you can see. You have to click on that wheel. Then this window will come where you can, if you have made any mistake in your class name, section, room, whatever it is, you can change here. So it's nothing like whatever we have created is static. It's always dynamic. If you want to make any changes, you can of course do that. So this is, we are not going to practice. This is just for your information. This is how we will change the class setting. Now coming to the theme settings. See, Google is having some default themes. This is what you see in this as my backdrop of this classroom, Google Classroom. This is also another classroom. So behind this as my backdrop, as my background, there is something, there is some image, okay. So if you want to change that image, you have to go to this, you have to go to your classroom first, then you can select the theme, or you can, if you have any images or photographs at your end in your desktop that you can upload. Friends, this is how you will change your theme, your backdrop of your background of your classroom. Now we are going to the next section. See, as I was saying in the beginning, in traditional classroom, teaching, learning, everything happens. And many a times the teacher also gives some kind of announcements every day. For example, students, the teacher will, you know, tell like, students, you have to submit so and so assignment on so and so date. This is one announcement teacher that makes. You have to complete this project so and so on time. And teacher will give a deadline due date. Okay. Similarly, the same process, the same announcements can be made in Google Classroom also. For that, what you have to do, what facility in Google Classroom you can use. If you want to make, as a teacher, if you want to make any announcements in your class, you have to click on this stream. On the top, you can see this is my classroom. Friends, please listen. This is my classroom, SEMCA workshop. When you click on SEMCA workshop, this classroom, this window comes. You can see on the top, stream, classwork, people, grades. If you want to make any announcements to your students, the way I was giving some examples, you have to click on the stream. Then you can share something with your class. You can see this, share something with your class. I have, you know, shown in red arrow mark also. So this is the place where you have to type your matter, your assignment. Dear students, so and so, you will be having an online lecture, kindly attend. You can mention the date, the topic, everything. Students, you have to submit so and so assignment on so and so date. So for making, giving all such kind of announcement in Google Classroom, stream is the place. This is one thing regarding Google Classroom. Okay. Next thing is how you will create topic and why we are creating topic in Google Classroom. Let me, you know, guide you through example. This is my Google Classroom, which I am running. This is for my PGDET students. I am the coordinator of, along with Dr. Sutapa, I am the coordinator of Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Technology program. This is one of the PG diploma programs offered by IGNOU. So when I created a Google class for my PGDET students, I have, you know, created topics like general announcement, then PDF self-learning. You can see on the left, PDF self-learning materials, program guide, assignment, IGNOU announcements. So these many topics I have created. So whatever, you know, announcement comes from IGNOU side, I'll be posting that in general announcement. If I get some PDF material related to my course, I'll be posting in this topic. If, of course, there will be a program guide that will be available in program guide, then the assignment will be posted in assignment. So this is why you are creating the topic. It's absolutely up to the teacher. It's not necessary to create the topic also, but to bring a beauty to your classroom, it's always better to have topic-wise arrangement in your classroom so that students will find it very easy. They don't have to struggle, you know, search here and there for whatever materials that they are looking for. So this is how it is done, how you are creating, how you will create a topic. So it's better to start with the topic, creating a, you know, I mean, like you first start with creating a topic. So to create a topic, what you have to do, you have to go to your classroom. This is my classroom. This is another classroom, test, B.Ed, for B.Ed students. I have shown you stream, then I'll go to classwork. Okay, I will click on classwork. When you click on classwork, this kind of a window comes where you can see something called create, and to left of that, there is a plus sign. So when you click on this create, this window comes, this small window where you can see assignments, quiz assignments, questions, material, reuse, post, and topic. At the lower side of this small window, you can see the topic. So this is the place. This is the, you know, facility or link which you can use for creating topic. You have to click on this first topic. Then another window comes where you have to, you know, give the topic title and all. So in through that topic, you can create, you know, you can create topics like announcement, self-learning materials, program guide, assignments. If you have video materials, you can have a video topic also. If you have audio, so audio topic, you have a topic on audio. If you have some OER materials, you can have topic for OER. So that way, it's up to the teacher to design what all topics you need to have in your classroom. Friends, we are also not going to, I mean, like practice that. You may practice at your end. Okay. Now, this is the, you know, important part of our Google Classroom where the teacher is trying to disseminate knowledge, trying to engage with the students through teachers' learning materials. For, I mean, like open distance education faculties, it is very easy. I mean, like we have already the self-learning materials, but for a teacher from traditional or face-to-face university or college or any school education, they have to create learning materials. Friends, this is very important. They have to create learning materials. Those teachers from school, higher education, which are face-to-face or traditional, they have to create learning materials. So for creating learning materials, we will have sessions. Like one thing is Dr. Ashish had a session. He was saying about YouTube, how you can create YouTube videos. Then Dr. Nisha will tell about many things. Mustafa will tell about, Professor Mustafa will tell about how you can create OER. So for a higher education teacher, they can use all those facilities to create digital materials, digital content. And this is what I was given as a pre-workshop activity. I think you have ready with some of the learning materials, like you have a video which is beneficial for teaching your course. You have some audio materials. You have some kind of images, web links related to your program. All those materials will be posted in your classwork. So classwork is the place in Google Classroom to share the learning materials to your students. Let me repeat. Classwork is the place where the teacher places or uploads all the learning materials for the benefit of the students. So this is how it is done. You can see in the slide. You have to go to your classroom. Sorry, first, then you have to click on classwork. First, click on classwork. Then this create window will come. You have to click on this. Then this small window will come. Assignment, choose assignment material, question material. Okay. So this is the place where you will upload whatever kind of digital material, whatever kind of e-materials, e-contents are available with you. This is the place to upload all those materials to your students. So friends, we will practice that. When you are clicking on create, Google have, as Dr. Ashish said, Google have many tools. These many tools are integrated with the Google Classroom. I'll show you that also. When you click on create, there is an option for getting all this. So you will find Google Docs, Google Slide Sheets, drawings, and forms. Okay, these many Google tools are integrated in the Google Classroom. We have a Microsoft equivalent, which we are very familiar with. Okay, in place of Google Docs, in Microsoft, we use Microsoft Word. For slides, we use Microsoft PowerPoint. For sheets, it is Microsoft Excel. For drawing pictures, images, design your brochures, we use Microsoft Publisher. And for polling, creating surveys, creating tests, you will use Google Form. Then Microsoft is having Microsoft Forms. Okay, only the difference is very simple. Google Forms are free, while proprietary, Microsoft tools are proprietary. So it's always, you know, good to go with the free tools. So these many tools are integrated in Google Classroom, which of course you can use. So what I'm trying to make is, even if you are not having the Microsoft package with you, which you have to pay a good amount for getting the Microsoft package, there is absolutely nothing to worry. You can use all those Microsoft equivalent Google tools in your Google Classroom. Very easy. Okay, friends, now let me again take you to my, what we call the classroom. This is the classroom. For the time being, I'm taking this classroom. Please listen, this is, you have to practice now. I'll give 2-3 minutes again. I'll click on my classroom, Semka UUU. Okay, I'll go to classroom. First, I will click on my classes. You can click on this button also, you will get it from here also. I'll click on my classroom. You click on classwork. See, classwork is coming. You have to click on create. First, go to your classroom, click on classwork, then click on create. I think it's visible, create. Then you come down, create, click on material. First, click on classwork, then create, then click on material. When you are clicking material, I mean, like this window, message window will come. You have to give a title, okay? Video program. For example, I'm typing video program. Description. You will give the description to the students. Dear learners, please watch. It's up to you. You can, dear students, please watch the program. This you will type. Then, as I said, Either you can go with the create button or you can add material. First we will see how we can create with this. Okay, create. When you click on create, docs, slides, everything will come. So with this, it is, you know, sure that you can't create any video, okay? Because video, there is nothing, you know, there is no tool available for creating that way with available tools here. So suppose I am, I mean, like, since we have given video program, we will absolutely, we will upload video only. Suppose I am, you know, uploading some document Word file, I will create, I'll click on create, then I will click on docs. See, friends, what is happening? You will click on docs. Okay. When you are clicking docs, this is how it is happening in all whatever material you are creating. Okay. See, I was on the top, you can see I was on this page. Then I created, I clicked on create. Then I clicked on Google Docs. Then another window was opened. So this is the Google Doc. Okay, this is the Google Doc window. So this is the place where you have to create your digital material, e-material. Suppose you are creating a document file for your student. For example, what is technology integration? You are writing a, I mean, like some kind of input on technology integration. So whatever options are available in your Microsoft Word, almost all those options are available in Google Doc also. Friends, very simple. So you type, you create all the materials, whatever you want. Okay, you type whatever matter you want your students to read, all things can be typed here. Once it is done, sorry, you have to click on title also, okay? Technology integration, what is technology? It's automatically sometimes it takes from our title. So you have to give first, let me repeat, you have to give all the details, then create. Then this window comes where you will give the title. Then you will type all your materials. Once this is done, you can see all changes saved in Drive. Okay. And where does this get changed? I was saying in the beginning, there is a folder for your Google Classroom. So this document automatically gets stored in your Google Drive. This is the beauty. You don't have to save it now. All changes saved in your Drive. Friends, let me repeat. This document will be automatically stored in your Google Drive, which is there in your, sorry, folder in your Google Drive, which is created for this particular Google Classroom. So once your material, document, digital content is ready, only thing you have to do is you have to simply close that window. Okay. Then, so your material is ready. It is ready in your Google folder, in your Google Drive. After creating that, you have to post this. Okay, I'll come to that. After creating your Google Doc, you have to post this. There are many options that we are not going to discuss that. Okay, suppose if you want to add your video program, friends, very simple. We have a title video program. We have given the description. You click on add. Okay, so then this small window comes, where you can take materials from Google Drive. If you have many folders in your Google Drive, apart from your Google Classroom folder, you can take material from your Google Drive. You have to click on that. If you want to give any website link, you have to click on that. If you want to attach any file like video program that you have created in whatever format that you can attach. If you want to attach YouTube videos, you have to click on this. So for the time being, I am clicking on file. So all those options will come. Either you can drag file from your desktop. Simply, I'm showing you simply, if you have a file here, you simply click and drag to your this place. Okay. Otherwise, select files from your device. Click on that. Select file from your device. Very simple. So you select the file. If you want to select any file, video, audio, any file, you have to simply select that. Okay. So I'm stopping that for the time being. I'm not uploading anything. Friends, I'm giving you some 5 minutes time. You can simply practice this, how you can upload materials. I hope you have 1 minute. Friends, 1 minute. Sorry, friends, since it is working from home, my son was trying to join with me. Sorry for the disturbance. I hope now you are practicing that. So once you have done, you have to simply post it, okay?
Ajit, there is two basic questions from two participants. If you will address that, that will be very good. And Mohammed Manor Hussain, I think he's from Bangladesh. And he's asking that, I already have Google Classroom on my personal and institutional ID. Do I have to create a new classroom again?
For number practicing?
One. Yeah, number one. Number two, Palash Shaha, she's asking that what is the purpose of section and room in Google Classroom? Is it possible to create multiple sections for a single class? This is two questions. You can also read the questions from using QA box.
For Mo Hussain, I would say it's better to create a classroom now, because since we are practicing. If you are like an expert in Google Classroom, there is no need. But I would suggest for practicing, you can create a classroom. The second question is, what is the purpose of section and room? Section is your what we call the if you have BA classroom, for example, if you have 1,000 learners or students in your BA classroom, you can have what I was saying in the beginning, one section for BA first year, one section for the next. In a single Google classroom, you can accommodate only 250 students. So then one section will be for first 250 students. For that people, that learners, you will create a room, separate room. Then for the next 250 students, you will have second section. For them, you will create a second room. Then for next batch, you will create another section, again a room. This is how it goes. So basically, your section is nothing but your classroom, kind of a description. What kind of a classroom it is, which students it is catering to. And the room is like, how many students will be there in a classroom, and how many we can accommodate in a classroom. And for first 250 students, there will be a separate room. So whatever material you are creating for room one, the same will be replicated in, the second room also, the third room also. If you have 10,000 students, there will be multiple number of rooms. So you have to create only one section in a Google Classroom that can be replicated for all the rooms in your classroom. Okay, we will have more discussion in our WhatsApp also. So friends, I think you have done your some kind of uploading in your Google Classroom. Now let us move on to our next section. So friends, so this is the place where we were having. Okay, this is how we will create Google Docs, we will share materials and all. Okay, this is how teacher will share the materials. Now coming to, once you have done away with all your uploading, you have uploaded many things, video, audio, everything you have done. Now, if there is some mistake, by mistake, you have given introduction at the lower side of your topic, okay? You can see on the left. In this case, introduction to e-module. This is one of my class where introduction I have given in the beginning, on the beginning. While final test is at the lower part of my Google class. This is how it has to be logically sequenced. Okay. Suppose by mistake, if your introduction is on the lower side and final test is on the top, then it's not logically correct. This is incorrect sequencing. So then you have to, you can rearrange your topics also. Only thing you have to do is you have to come to your classwork, click on these three dots, then this window will come, rename, delete, copy link, move down. Okay. If you want to move this section to the lower part, you have to simply click on move down, then it comes to here. Then from there again, you click on move down and it goes down, down, down. Okay. If you want to move some topics above, the same day you can use this option, move up. So this is how you will rearrange your topics material. This can be done in every, like the content that you are adding also. If you have done some mistake when you are organizing or uploading your materials, definitely that can be rearranged, very simple. This is how it is done. We are not going to practice that. Now, the second thing, what Ashish was also saying, teachers usually give assignment for completing what we call the project. There can have some home assignments. There can have something to prepare in whatever digital material. So there can have many assignments and teachers usually give many assignments. So where does teacher give the assignment to the students? This is one thing. Number you have to give grade to the students also in assignment. When they submit assignment, the students will submit the assignment to the teacher. The teacher will evaluate the assignment, then will give, return to the students by giving some mark or grade. So this is how it is done. This also may be one you can practice classwork. Again, come to your classwork first, then create. You can see the first is assignment. We have used material. You have to click on assignment. I'll show you from my screen also. Friends, come to classwork. Only one I'll demonstrate this, you will practice. We won't be practicing first. Come to classwork, then click on create, click on assignment. See, it is almost similar to what we have seen when we have created the material, learning materials. Okay, you give title assignment one. Assignment one, give instruction, please complete. So you can give the data and all here, but there is another place where you can give. There are multiple options. Okay. So if you want to attach any materials related to your assignment, suppose the students want to read a PDF file and attempt the assignment, you can attach the file from here. Or if you want the students to watch some video program and attend the assignment, they have to attach the YouTube here. If you want to create, as a teacher, if you want to create assignment in Docs or slides or whatever Google tools, you can use this option. Or else simply you can type your question here also. Okay. Please conduct a survey on digital repositories. This is the question. You can give the question here also. Okay. Then you on the right, you can see many options. If you have many class, all the classes will be listed. To which class you are giving this, that you have to select from here. Then whether it is for all the students, that you have to click here. Otherwise, if you want to restrict, you have to restrict that. And what is the mark you are going to give? You can give from here. If you are giving 10 marks, you make it 10. If there is a due date, you click the date from here. Okay. Then, as I was saying in the beginning, if it is related to some topic, you can choose the topic from here. Otherwise, leave as it is. Friends, the second beauty, another advantage is you can create a rubric also, which is a entirely different concept. We are not going into that. It takes too much time also, rubric. If you want to create a rubric, you can use this option. This is also, it's a time consuming process, originality report, which is something related to plagiarism checking. For example, suppose your students are preparing an assignment, copying some material from the internet. And if the students want to check that document, whether it is plagiarized or not, students have the option. Okay. So you can give this option to the students, but there is a limit, only three checkings per assignments will be available. So if you want your students to check their document for plagiarism, you can click on this. I'm not going into detail that there are many things associated to both originality report and rubrics. Okay, so this is done. Everything you will fill up, then simply after completing all this, you have to assign. Don't forget to assign that. Then only it will go to all the students. When you assign something, automatically all the students will get an information. My teacher has posted something in my classroom. So friends, very simple. After filling all your assignments, simply click on assign. So things will be assigned. Okay. Now it will go to all the students. Will get the information that so and so assignment has been posted in my classroom. This is how it is done. Now let me come to choose assignment. Okay, we have discussed about material, we have done topic, we have done assignment, we have done. Now after end of the year, any unit, or if you want to have a formative assessment, or if you want to conduct a determined examination, for all those kinds of testings and evaluation or assessment, you will use this option, which is Q's assignment, which is titled as Q's assignment. This is basically nothing but this is Q's assignment. Very simple. Go to this, then go to classwork, create, then click on Q's assignment. This is how this is done. I'll show you that. I'll also give you a demo. Then creating questions. Okay, friends, even Ashish was telling about this. In classroom, both the teachers and students communicate, the students communicate themselves. And in virtual space, there is an alternative which is called the discussion board. So what are those who have done any MOOC program, whatever MOOC programs are there in the world, most of the MOOC programs or online programs have this facility of discussion board. Where discussion forum, which will give the teachers and students and the students to for teachers and students to communicate or to have a communication between students and students, between the students or among the students. So this is the place for creating such discussion forum questions. As you see, we have assignment, then for test, creating test, then there is something called question, which is nothing but the discussion forum in your Google Classroom. Pretty simple. Assignment, use assignment, questions, which is nothing but the discussion forum. Show you how it is done. Classwork, I'll show you how the tests are created, assessment questions are. You go to classwork, then click on choose assignment. Okay. So you will write your title first, test one. You will give complete, please attempt the test. Very simple. Don't mind about these spellings. Okay, so when this is done, automatically it generates a blank Q's form, which is in Google Forms. Okay, or you can simply click on create from here also, you can click forms, but by default the Google Classroom, it creates a blank Q's. Okay, so now you have to, what we have to do, we have to create the queues. For creating the queues or test, we will click on blank queues. Okay, one more thing, there is something called grade inverting, which we are not going to discuss. You can keep it off, on or off. If you are clicking on, when the students take the assessment test through Google Forms, the grade, the mark they are getting will be automatically added to your Google Classroom in that student's account. So very simple. But there are some complications which are associated with the grade inverting. So better you keep it, for the time being, you keep it switched off. We'll discuss that later, okay? You can give manual grading also. When the students attempt the test, you can give manual grading also. Then there is something called the locked mode on Chromebooks. Chromebook is nothing but it's a kind of a laptop. It's a laptop which works on Linux-based softwares, okay? So some institution gives Chromebooks to their students. Some institutions gives Chromebook to their students. So when students are attempting the test using the Chromebook, the laptop provided by the school, they cannot access any other website. this is the beauty part of, you know, switching on this locked mode on Chromebooks. Okay, this is one of the security part of Google Form. So any of your organization, if you are conducting the exam through Chromebook laptop, you can switch on this. So when the students attempt the test, they can't, you know, refer or search any other website. Only they can attempt the test. But those who are, using casually, there is no meaning in locked mode on Chromebooks. There is, you know, a lot of security issues. When the students attempt the test, they will search other website. They can see the Google Classroom. They can see everything. So that is one of the limitations, maybe we can say. So now I will click on Google, you know, blank quiz. See what is happening. I just clicked on blank quiz. Okay, then the blank quiz. And Ashish was, already he had a discussion regarding blank quiz. You have to give the title here. Unit test one. When you type the title here, automatically it, fills here also. But since the length is low, I think it is not getting switched on. Okay, now you can start, as you were saying, you can start all the questions. You have plenty of options. You can have short answer questions, essay type questions for which you have to use the paragraph, multiple choice, everything. Very simple. This is nothing, different from what we are creating for, research purpose, collecting data from students. Then one more thing I have to, this is my G Suite account, okay? So when I am creating Google Classroom blank quiz in my G Suite account, students, those who are joining with their personal Gmail ID cannot access the quiz or test we are creating. So if you want our students to attempt our test, you have to untick this, okay? If you want only your students to attend you, quiz, you have to tick on this. Otherwise, when the students start attempting the test, they will, send a mail. Automatically, we will get a mail that so-and-so student is asking for attempting the test. Then we have to give the permission and all. First of the things Ashish was saying, all those you can give, everything. If you want to have Chromebook mode, it's, confusing or will be difficult to practice. But the student, organization having Chromebook, they can definitely switch on this. Then rest of the things is okay. So friends, again, let me give a quest title. What is okay? So I'm giving, see, you can see it saving. Okay. So all changes saved in Drive. So whatever questions or test I am creating here will automatically get saved in your, what we call the folder, which is there in our Google Drive. So you don't have to save it again. Okay. Once this test or unit test or QC is done, you have to simply, as we have done in the case of assignments, you have to simply close that window, okay? And this is done, your QC is ready and it will be there in your folder in the Google Drive. Okay, now you have to fill all these details to whom you are creating the points, due date, topic. If you want the rubric, originality report, everything you can. Now, after completing all those, you have to simply click on assign. Friends, let me repeat, completing all those, you will create the Google quiz in your Google form, then it will get automatically saved. After completing that, you close that window, then come to this window, then you simply assign to your students. Now this will be available in your Google Classroom. The students will get a message. They will get the message regarding the due date and everything. So everything is done now. Google quiz is done, okay? For creating now, coming to the, what we call the discussion forum question. For that, come to classwork, click on create, click on question. Okay, your question you will, what is internet? Bad effects of, what are the bad effects of internet? Okay, a kind of a question which the students can collaboratively discuss. Very simple. What are the benefits of, bad effects of internet? You give instruction, one, students have to, maintain their etiquette and everything. They have to participate, they can give as many response as they wish. All those kinds of instruction you can give. If you want to attach any materials related to that, you can attach. If you want to create this question, what are the bad effects of internet using any of this, you can use this. See, then to the right, you can see students can reply to each other. This also you have to tick that, then only students can reply to other student. This is what usually happens in a discussion forum. I will be posting, or any student will be posting a comment to my question, then rest of the students keep on adding to that comment. So if you want your students to access, have such a facility, you have to click on this. Students can reply to each other. Once this is done, you have to simply ask. Earlier we were seeing assign, now it is ask. So you can ask this question to the student. I think you are visible on the right extreme top. You have to assign this or ask your students. Okay. So that is done. So you can see this is, these are the classwork the students has to do. I have created a material video program, then one assignment, then we had a test, then we have given something for discussion, for discussion. So this is how it is done. You can add the learning materials, you create assignment, test, and discussion forum. So a major part of the Google Classroom is now over. Friends, a major part of our Google Classroom, uploading, creating, everything is done. This is the basics about the Google Classroom, how you do. Now let us discuss something more. Coming to my presentation again. From current slide, I'll now quickly move to my rest of the slides. We'll see how many time we can practice. Okay, friends, in the beginning I was saying there are two accounts, Gmail personal, G Suite account. Very recently only Google made the Google Meet free for the personal Gmail users also. Okay, earlier this was not the case. Google Meet was not free for all the Gmail account holders. If you go to your Google Classroom through your G Suite account, let me repeat. If you go to your Google Classroom through G Suite account, you can see this on the top, you can see the gear, this wheel. You have to click on that. When you click on that, you will see class code, stream, everything you'll see. After that, you will find Meet. Okay, you will find Meet. This is the place where you can generate the Google Meet, like the Zoom meeting ID. This is the place where you can create your Google Meet ID. Google Meet, what we call the link. Okay. If you want to make it visible to the students, you can click on this. Okay. So friends, this is the place where you can, create or organize a video lecture. This is the place in your Google Classroom. Friends, let me again repeat, you go to this Google Classroom, click on your wheel, then you create a link for your online lecture by clicking this arrow mark. Then your Google Meet link is ready. This is one thing. Number second is, this is only available in G Suite. Okay. For the time being, I don't know if you are using the personal Gmail ID. I think in your personal Gmail ID Classroom, this facility is not available. Let me repeat, this is, you can organize Google Meet or online lecture through G Suite account only, which is not available in your, what we call the personal Gmail ID. But there are plenty of options how you can use to connect with your students through online lecture. In your personal Gmail ID, if you see on the left side, there is something called the new Google Meet. This is something which has come up in the last 2 weeks. Okay, Google has made Google Meet free for all the Gmail users, but it is not for the Google Classroom. So this is, these are the two things which you have to, know about Google Meet. So then where the link will be available? Again, this is, there are differences in your personal and G Suite account. If you are using your G Suite account, go to your classroom. This is one classroom which I have created, where you can find the, what we call the Google Meet link here. Okay. Or if you're clicking on classwork, there is something called Google Meet here. That also, there also you can find the Google Meet link. This meeting link can be shared through any social media, as Ashish was saying, or you can, you know, paste this in your stream, share something with your class. There also you can simply copy and paste it here. So students will know this is the Google Meet link for online lecture. Then you have to simply, you know, I mean, like, give all the details. So and so, so topic will be, you know, discussed. This is from so and so topic. This is the time. This is the link. So then students can easily access that. So this interface, what you are seeing, this is only for G Suite account holders. In personal Gmail account or Google, if you are accessing Google Classroom through personal Gmail, this link will not be available to neither the teacher nor the students. Okay, you will not see this kind of a link in your classroom dashboard. Now, how we will conduct? Okay, you have to simply click on that link. As a teacher, you have to simply click on that link. Then this interface will come. Simply click on join now. This is one of the interface which we have done. I mean, like yesterday, Dr. Nisha Singh, who is the resource person for tomorrow's session, she was having a class, online class with our PGDET learners yesterday. So this screenshot I had taken from that session only. Okay, see, we have few students only, but this is how it looks like. Okay, you have to simply click on that link and this interface will come. Then, I mean, like, you can join, then students can also join. But if you are using G Suite account, students will find, you know, difficult in joining your online lecture. So friends, this is another, you know, point which is related to the Google Classroom and which is related to what we call the traditional classroom. In traditional classroom, we are teaching the students to face to face, but the alternative or the replica of that real face to face physical face-to-face teaching is through online lectures in Google Classroom. So almost we have covered like whatever facilities are there in the traditional classroom are available in our virtual classroom also. But only thing is that you have to have the G Suite account, and it is better to have a G Suite account. And your organization has to take a lead in taking the G Suite account. Now, I will quickly, you know, glance through some of the what we call rest of the settings, like, okay, how teacher can add students to the classroom. Okay, you go to your classroom. On the top you will see stream, which is the place for giving announcements, then classroom, where we will upload all our materials. Then there is something called the pupil. This is the place where you can add your students. Okay, there are two ways majorly. Okay, you have to simply click on pupil, then this window comes. You have to click on this small, there is a, you know, icon here with the plus sign. I think it is visible. You can click on this plus sign. Then whoever there is in your Gmail ID, whatever Gmail IDs are stored in your Gmail account, all those will be listed here. Okay, all those will be listed here. If nothing, I mean, like, if you don't have any Gmail IDs of your students, you have to simply click here and you have to type. Okay, then you can send an invitation to your students. When you are typing an invitation, everything will come. Okay, on the right side you can see that. So this is how it is. I mean, like, you will add your students one way. When you send an invitation to your students, students will get a message like this. Okay, they will open their Gmail. You will get so and so person have invited to join the Google Classroom. Then the student, your learner, has to click on this join. The student will click on this join. Okay. Then this interface, this message box comes. If the student is having multiple Gmail accounts, they will ask for which account the student wish to join. Then simply click on join. Then the student will be, you know, will be a student of your Google Classroom. When the student click on this, that particular student will be a student of your Google Classroom. Okay, this is one way. Second way is you can give, rather than typing the Google Classroom, what we call the Gmail ID of the students, you can go to your Google Classroom. You can see something like class code here in very small letters. Okay, class code here. there is something called class code. You simply click on that box. You simply click on this small, incomplete box. When you click on that incomplete box, your class code will be enlarged. When you click on that small box, this will be enlarged. So you can, it's visible now, your Google Classroom code. So what you have to do, you have to simply send this Google Classroom code to your student. You can use WhatsApp, you can use any other social media tools, you can use your email, any kind of communication channel you can use. So students will get this, what we call the class code. Then students will go to their Google Classroom through the email, through their personal Gmail, the way the teachers were doing, the way we were doing. As I said, there are two options. One is for joining class, the other is for creating class. Joining class, creating. So students will click on this plus sign, then they will click on join class. Okay. When they click on join class, the Google Classroom will ask for the class code. So they can simply, copy the class code available with the students. And by that way, students can join the classroom. So that is how the students will join the classroom. Now, I think I have 2-3 slides more. I'll be completing soon. Hope I'm not clear to everyone.
Okay. Yeah, so far, Ajit, we got a few questions also. After you can another 2 minutes to. Then you can address a few questions which is relevant to address here. Otherwise, you can address through WhatsApp group.
Okay. So where students will find their classwork? Students will join the classroom. So our interface as a teacher will be different. Students' interface will be different. See, in teacher's interface, we were seeing stream, classwork, people, and grades also. Grades was one more link was there in teacher's account. But for students, it is not there. Students can see only stream, classwork, and people. Okay. So if you want to students, whatever activities they have to complete, they have to click on classwork, then they can see this view your work. This is the place where students will find the activities to be done in the classroom. Many things are there, which we have to discuss later, how they will complete the activity and how they will submit. Few I'll discuss, very quickly. So if the students want to submit this assignment one, they will click on assignment. Then this interface, this message box will come. Then they have to click on add or create, or they can use the, if they want to see the question, they can see here, otherwise it will be available here only. Then they will click on add or create. Then they will get the Google document. If you want to select PowerPoint, they can choose PowerPoint also. Then after completing the answer, the student teacher was giving some assignment. Then students give the what we call the result, response. They will be typing. After typing, that has to be sent to the teacher. So this is the place where students sends the assignment to this teacher. Turn in. Okay. After completing this, students has to turn in. They have to turn in. So this is how they will submit the assignment. Now, where the teacher will find the students' work. This is our teacher's interface: stream, classwork, people, grades. Okay, teacher will click on classwork on the left side. Assignment one, there was something called assignment one. Teacher will click on assignment, then view assignment. When the teacher clicks on this view assignment, this interface comes. Then teacher click on student work. So whoever is, have submitted the assignment, teacher can see here. There are two students. They can see the assignment here. Teacher has to click on this assignment. Then it takes to some other place where the students can give the mark and all. So that is the place. Okay. Now where teacher will find student mark, this is the place on the interface. On the main dashboard, you can see I was saying one box. This will lead to your Google folder. This arrow mark will lead to the grade section. Okay. When the teacher click on this arrow mark, the teacher can see the student's mark, or the teacher can click on grades. Let us see how it will appear. This is how the teacher will see the grades of the students. Okay. you can see all the details, like as a teacher I had given 55 marks, this is missing, the student has not submitted anything, I had given 2 marks here, student has not submitted, not turned in, I mean like if the student has not submitted the assignment. So this is how, if you have number of students, all the students' details will be appearing here, who all have submitted the assignment, who all not submitted, all those details will be available here. Okay friends, my presentation is into the last no mode. Very simple question, whether this is possible. Of course, I was hinting that we have, not because of this COVID, but that was also one of the reasons, we have created a Google Classroom for our PGDET learners. This is the classroom. Then we have made available all the PDF materials. We have, you know, we are conducting regular lectures frequently through our Google Classroom, and what the feedback we are getting is students are, you know, feeling happy in having such a kind of a communication. So of course you can go with Google Classroom, where it is useful for sharing all the materials, you can conduct whatever is possible in a traditional classroom, which is equally possible in virtual classroom also. So I wish many of you are running the Google Classroom, but those who are not into Google Classroom, virtual classroom, I hope they can also start a Google Classroom to engage their students and have a, you know, real-time communication with the students, both possible in traditional and virtual, sorry, ODL institutions. I hope things are clear. We couldn't, you know, go with more hands-on practice, but we have created, we have done 2-3 activities. Hope in the coming sessions we will more focus on hands-on sessions. A little bit of limitation was there since it is a 1.5-hour session. And this is the activity for you, which I'll post in your Moodle account also. You create a Google Classroom, then upload few learning materials which you have already developed. Then add few pupils, your SEMCAP people, Open University expert. Then kindly add me also, so that I'll get a feel how you have done your work. Thank you all the team. Thank you Samka, UOU, and I thank all the participants for their patient listening. Thank you from my side.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Ajit ji. It's really very nice and practical based training which is you provided. I know that the entire training will goes on in the Moodle platform as well as the WhatsApp which is created. The same activity you are going to post in the WhatsApp group also, and which can be accessed through Moodle LMS. Thank you very much. And there are many people wants to interact with you, and they posted few questions also. And these questions you can address through WhatsApp group. It is more easy, and through Moodle platform as well. And looking into the time constraint, we can move to the closing of this today's session, the live session, of course, and asynchronous we will go in different platform, which is Moodle LMS as well as WhatsApp group. So now I would like to request Professor Madhu Parar to have concluding remarks on today's proceedings, and take few feedbacks from the participants as well and the panelists who are available here. Thank you very much.
Friends, I would like to firstly thank Dr. Ajit, our colleague from IGNO, for this presentation and explaining us about the Google Classroom. Maybe many of you know about Google Classroom, or you are using Google Classrooms, but you can, those who know and those who don't know, you can further discover this now, because this is going to be the future, and you need to be connected to your students. So that is the mode. Google Classroom is one mode. There can be another modes also. So you have to choose, you have to decide what you want, what is convenient with you, what the learners in your country or in your situation, in your district, like if I say Uttarakhand Open University, would like. It will also depend upon the number of the students. Maybe let's say in a subject like history, there are more than 1,000 students in one class or with one teacher. Maybe in subjects like computer science, there are less. Maybe in subjects like, let's say, data science, there are even less, and so on and so forth. So you need to decide, each one of us need to decide what tool, what mode we have to use and apply. And let me tell you, this is a self-learning, actually. This is 1.5 hours is just to ignite again or the minds and your thoughts. And then just from here, you have to move on. Like you are doing it on the WhatsApp, you are doing it through Moodle, and so on and so forth. So with these words, maybe you all can have your question answers through WhatsApp as well as Moodle. I would like to thank Ajit. I would like to thank all my other colleagues from India, Sri Lanka, and Bangladesh.
Thank you, ma'am.
Gopal wants to add something here. Or other, Dr. Gopal?
Hello. Namaskar. Good afternoon. Was a very good experience. Thanks to our expert, Dr. Ajit.
Thank you.
And I hope so. The participants got the good learning experience, and I think that will inspire our participants to move towards digital teaching learning mediums. 1.5 hour discussion was very good about Google Classrooms, too many things, how to use, how to integrate the material, the links, web links, Google Meet, whatever. Was a very good learning experience. Once more, thanks to all the participants, our panelists, our Professor Madhu Ma'am, and all our those are joining the meeting. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
We will see you all tomorrow morning with a new concept, with a new theme at 10:30. Okay then.
Thank
bye
you.
From all
thank
of us.
Thank you very much, Professor Madhu Prar. Thank you very much, Dr. Gopal. And tomorrow morning with us, Dr. Nishat Singh, and she will talk about the different tools, which is free and open source softwares, which can be integrated in the teaching and learning at different levels of education. And thank you very much. And tomorrow morning at 10:30, you can join with using the same link, same password, don't forget. And use this same link, same password, and join with us and interact with Dr. Nisha Singh. She will speaking about the first technologies in education, better teaching and learning. Thank you very much for joining with us.
Thank you.